Okay, hello. Today we're going to try something slightly different. And we're going to tell you how to create an ASMR unboxing video. And for this, I'm going to rely on my assistant, Kevin, here to act under my instructions. So, Kevin, firstly, if you'd like to put on the brand channel gloves. And while you're putting the gloves on, if you hold your hands up against the microphones here and here, you'll get sounds into the ears. Yes, so you've got the gloves on. Okay. So after making some nice noises, obviously you want to inspect the box. So pick the box up, bring it close to camera. Really explore every crevice, every nook and cranny. Be mindful of what the box is made of. Is it organic? Is it man-made? What is in the box? Is what's in the box important? Is it important to you? Is it important to the audience? Yes, tapping's good, lots of tapping. If you can move your fingers along and maybe make some, yes, that sort of noise, and on the box itself. So if we start trying to actually open the box itself by maybe perhaps peeling one end open, if we can. Very slowly, very mindfully. Don't want to do anything too fast. Take it slow. And as you're bringing things closer to the camera, do keep an eye on the focus of the image. Because although this is primarily about audio, we do know that we live in an ocular society. And they do prefer to see things that look pleasant rather than out of focus and overexposed. Have we got into the box yet, Kevin?
No.
It does appear as though you're having some trouble. I mean, there's two options. You could get slightly more forceful with trying to get your claws into that box, or I do see an alternative pair of gloves there, which, if you feel they would assist you in making the task easier, I'm quite happy for you to change your gloves. But entirely, the choice is up to you at this point. Like I say, we've got at least 10 minutes to get through it. Kind of 10 minutes is an optimum length of video. It's a piece of sellotape. It's kind of quite stuck, causing a problem on the claws.
Claw sharpening tools.
Well, feel free to stick a finger in if you know in the glove, keep the finger in the glove, but if you need to, or change to the rubber glove. But do remember my tip about putting them on really close to the microphone there on each side. This gives an ear-to-ear sensation, which most people appreciate, although obviously you do need to be listening on a stereo capable system. Also, while I'm thinking here, so I'm going to press record. Yes, I did press record. So yes, so we have the more standard attire for this channel. Yellow. Now, the reason we've finally decided on yellow for this channel is psychologically, it is more clickable colour. So when you see a thumbnail with a prominent yellow element, psychology says you are more likely to engage with that thumbnail.
Oops.
This saves me creating thousands of custom thumbnails, which I'm sure you can appreciate would be quite a job to accomplish. So I can see Kevin is still having some mild issues with that box, but he is making good progress there. Good progress. Remember, slow, stable, there's no hurry. No hurry at all. Just remember the tip about keeping things in focus as much as possible. And giving the camera a second or two to select its correct. It may be apparent that our studio here is not soundproofed from the external elements.
Dog tingles.
However, I am a big fan of Cinema Direct and Dogma 95, so it's all documentary. And you know, in 500 years' time, somebody can be watching this video because they were searching for dogs barking. Slow and steady. Very good. Very good. Okay, and at this point I would say now put the doll and the back card back down and pick up the outer box. And look at that, start maybe doing some tearing and some scrunching. See what noises it makes. Remember to do from left to right and up close to this microphone, up close to that microphone. Just keep it varied. That was the producer walking into the set. The producers are like. And just remember that the closer to a microphone that the noise occurs, the more kind of immersive it is for the listener. Do a tear from left to right or right to left. Bearing in mind you have a microphone here and a microphone here, so cross that way. There we go, very good. Thank you. I would say yes, I like the way this is heading. I think. Remove all the cardboard until you're left with that piece of plastic, and that piece of plastic, transparent plastic, will be very scrunchy. So there's some more tearing to remove the cardboard. Very good. Lots of cardboard on the floor of the studio that keeps stepping. And I would say at this point, if you scrunch that piece of cardboard up into a ball into your fist. Now make sure you frame it kind of fairly central. Oh, that's a nice noise. Maybe hold that right up to one of the microphones. That's good. Left to right, left to right, left to right. Yes, yeah, stereo. On your recording, fantastic. And then frame up that ball of cardboard on your palm and just flick it. Fantastic. So this should be quite crinkly and crunchy. Again, again, don't be afraid to hold things right up to the microphones and really scrunch it, scrunch it, scrunch it. Or maybe do a Rolf Harris effect. Not quite tie my kangaroo down, but it's not the same thing, is it? And I'm not sure we really want to bring the Harris into the channel.
It's family friendly asthma show.
Interestingly, actually, quite a few people say asthma, which to me sounds like asthma. I always say
ASMR.
But that's probably just me. And again, finish with a flip. Awesome. And I'll flick these pieces of cardboard off as well. Progress here. You see we've broken the 10 minutes mark, which is fantastic for Kevin's first unboxing video. We can expect some mistakes to happen. There's some dry leaves over here. Sort of tangent, but I'm in charge. Yes, and I can see the fastening mechanism for the card back so that it keeps the doll on the card back. And just for those interested, this doll was acquired at the pound shop, so you too could have one of these fine dolls for the sum of £1. So what's the exchange rate at the moment? US dollars?
140, 150.
So that's what, 60 cents? Not, it's not a whole lot of money. It's quite amazing, really.
Who wouldn't want to spend 60 cents on a doll like this? Oh. I think I'm getting tingles just unboxing.
Amazing. This is, I have to say, this is amazing for your, this is your first unboxing, I presume.
It is.
It's amazing.
You have to have money to buy things to be able to unbox them.
Poor credit. It's a decent credit rate. I won't tell you how much debt I have.
I can beat you with a student loan.
Actually, at work, your student loan will be low interest. My debt is credit card interest rates. But I do it for the fans.
I do it for the fans.
Is now a good time to talk about how advertising works? Probably not. We're not allowed to talk about advertising on a platform which uses advertising to support itself. But you know what you have to do, right? If you've made it this far through the video, you owe us. Right. I'll give Kevin his cut of like 2 cents in about 10 years.
Sensibly invested, I'll be able to buy one of these dolls before I retire.
Awesome. I don't know if I've got any scissors in here because should we do some hair cutting? But have a really good look at the doll. It's a saw. It's a little silver thing. So yeah, have a really good look at the sort of quality of the doll. You know, bearing in mind this cost one GB pound, one British pound.
She waves like the Queen.
So yeah, lots of robust play value in this toy. I think it may be worth taking a look at the backing cards as well. Give that a scrunch or a flick maybe, and that bit of white wiring thing if it's in frame, I'm not sure. It's a really good unboxing, aren't we? Well, is that 16 or 18 minutes? 16 minutes. That's very impressive. And just to answer any questions about the tech we're using in this video, we're on a Manfrotto, I think it's a Manfrotto Pixie lighting stand. We have a Joby tripod head and a square jellyfish metal tripod adapter for the phone. And the phone currently is a Sony Xperia XZ2. The main reason we got one of those for this channel is, if you look at the front of it, it's got a little BMO face, and how could you not buy that phone?
In honour of the World Cup.
Another mentioning the World Cup, another factor when you're making your unboxing video is to decide, is it going to be a topical video, or is it going to be an evergreen video, or perhaps something like the World Cup, a seasonal video, which, you know, when it comes to SEO, may crop up in search results seasonally. My understanding is that dialogue in YouTube videos does actually get indexed by robots as part of the meta tagging in SEO, so that's fascinating. So I would say flick the remainder of the packaging away. Let's get a clear table for the doll. Maybe just move these out of frame as well. Really start setting a focus for the forthcoming operation, as I do believe in doing full quality control tests on these dolls. Because, as I say, for a it's got underwear on this for a pound. That's quite impressive. So I think start dismantling the doll. Start applying light pressures and see if anything drops.
Before we dismantle the doll, this doll is a vampire and therefore will survive anything that we do to her beyond a stake through the heart.
Yeah. And I should also mention to viewers who are thinking of flagging this video, it's not real. Seriously, it's not real. I have a doll autopsy video that's basically been banned because people think it's real and it's a piece of plastic.
This is what happens on a night out in Portsmouth.
And you would know. I don't live in Portsmouth, not yet. Maybe that's why I want to move there.
Oh, Velcro.
saucy Velcro.
Expensive Velcro. Now that is quite interesting.
So she has moulded undergarments?
That was unexpected.
So there is no nudity in this video and no sexual content. Thank you, robots. So in terms of the clothing and the undergarments, that's actually for a pound, that's good value.
In a pinch, it makes a fascinating and classy cloak.
She's got her hair tied back at the moment.
We are one step elastic band away It's a night out in Portsmouth. Let your hair down.
And this is, of course, we're talking Portsmouth, Hampshire, United Kingdom, not Portsmouth, New Hampshire, US of A. I have no idea what goes on over there.
American stuff.
Is that, oh, she's still got, I thought she had a choker on then, but it's her cape. Her dress is now a cape. Impressive.
Her dress is about to be.
So don't be afraid to get a little rough at this point. We have to do full quality control. I'm not sure what the child's rating for this toy was. I would suggest it's probably 3 and above. So I guess do a limb test and see if the limbs break or come away from the body.
Surprisingly easily.
And just remember, we are on a stereo sound stage, so ear to ear, left to right is all good. If you do one thing on the left, one thing on the right, then the viewers and listeners will get a stereo experience. But as I say, this is an amazing first performance from Kevin. So it looks like she's got it going a bit bold on top there. Maybe inspect her scalp.
This is the first sign of it being quite a cheap doll.
I wonder if that's like real children's hair as well. Or is it vinyl hair? And I guess decapitation is, or maybe try tugging the hair, see if the head comes off or if it's fairly secure. So again, full quality assurance. That's quite some pressure, I can see there.
I don't think that was very good for sound, apart from me grunting. Here we go.
So fairly tough to decapitate with just hands.
I have some scissors.
What are you?
Yeah.
How long will it take to get them?
About a second and a half.
Okay, let's just get some scissors then. Oh, you've actually got them on you, in your pocket. Amazing. So not only is this an amazing, but keychain. Very well prepared.
Swiss Army knife. Who could be more prepared?
To see how much of that hair you can scalp cut off.
It's quite fashionable, so I gather, for young ladies to have short hair these days.
Well, fashion comes and goes, doesn't it? So does hair. Mostly goes. Gets to my age.
I would recommend, when cutting your hair at home, not using a Swiss Army knife. Other army knives are available.
Ones that aren't Swiss. I wonder if you can get a similar knife in the pound shop. That would be any good. And I wonder, now we've mentioned the word knife, if we're just going to get banned.
Ah!
Oh. Put nothing past those robots.
Don't buy knives, kids.
Oh, definitely not. Unless you're a chef. Well, I think we've hit over 25 minutes, which is amazing. Again, for the first ASMR unboxing video, Kevin has done an amazing job. And I think, unless there's any crescendo you wish to finish with, I think we can think about wrapping it up, and you can give your preferred hand signal to signify the end of the video. But if you want to carry on flicking, that's all good. And then, since I know how hard it is to have your hands put your hands back in frame, I know how hard it is to stop the camera with your hands in frame. I usually use my nose, but since I'm Kevin's assistant, I'm just going to do some ear to ear, and then I'm going to press stop for him. So remember, like, subscribe, share, and that other thing which we're not allowed to mention.